Hi everyone, I'm back with another full game review commentary. This time I'm playing Trundle in the jungle and against the Lee Sin, again. For the runes and masteries, there is a link in the description of the video, as well as timestamps of the plays and mistakes for those of you who don't like to rain around too much. Now, Trundle has got a lot of small buffs in the jungle. Sustain in the jungle is much easier nowadays. Your Hunter's Machete and Hunter's Talisman give a lot of health back. And of course, Trundle gets extra health back if he places his W under him. Same goes for red buff healing. Not only the smite, but also the passive regeneration. Trundle gets a lot more of it when his W is under him. And furthermore, there is another monster on the map, the Rift Herald. And Trundle's passive is, if an enemy dies near you, you get a percent of his maximum health. And when Rift Herald dies, Trundle gets a lot of health back. I'm gonna demonstrate that in this game. So you need to watch out for that later. It's insane how much health you get back. And it's pretty funny. Yeah, Trundle is mostly top played in the top lane or in the support role. But I like him jungle. Just because you don't know where he is. And then the pillars are even more dangerous than normal. I think pillar is one of the most OP abilities in the game. That constant slow around it is just so good. You can interrupt certain abilities with his E. Like a Zac E, for example. Or a Poppy Charge. You saw it in Worlds. If you watch it, it's insane what you can interrupt with it. And yeah, that pillar gives Trundle a very high skill cap. So yeah, I like to play him in the jungle. I was last pick here. I picked him on purpose. I counter their entire team. And yeah, we will see why. I counter them in different ways. I counter Lee Sin in jungle matchup, because Trundle is just far stronger than Lee Sin. Only level 6, that's a place I need to watch out for, but if he fights me one-on-one, like what happens here, he just doesn't know the matchup, because Trundle just wrecks him. Didn't need to flash there, he was already dead to my red buff, but yeah, I wanted to make sure Lee Sin has a shield, so just kill him. Just flash after him. Don't want to let him escape. Don't have first blood, because Syndra already got it. She sees me here. I just want the river crab. Still have my Crux buff, so I can take the river crab very fast. I want to take it on the other side as well, so might as well gank Syndra. And yeah, here you can see why Trundle is a good pick against Syndra. She's immobile, she has no way to go over my wall. So every time I come by and I put a wall down, she needs to flash. And when she doesn't have flash, she dies. That's how simple it is. Yeah, did a full clear, killed Lee Sin, and can clear again. That's the power of Trundle, I don't lose any health. I'm a very strong duelist. So I can just be the king in the jungle. Troll King! King! Yes. Yeah, it's a pretty good jungler for beginners as well. Because it's always nice if you don't lose any health in the jungle. You do need to master kiting a little bit. But in patch 6.20, kiting is made more easy. So yeah, try to figure it out. I see them fighting in the bot lane. I'm gonna drop by. Those two are immobile as well. Let's just grab the kill. I can't get to Lulu. She has a shield, a speed up, so not gonna dive her. She can even polymorph me. So yeah, the one kill was enough. Want to go back, spend my gold, but yeah, the Syndra is a bit overextended again. So I'm just gonna help out my Echo one more time. And the Syndra is overextended. She walks to a wall, and you shouldn't do that, because then I can block your entire passage off. Yeah, you can see how easy it is. The matchup Syndra against Echo, I know Syndra is gonna push early, because that's her advantage. She shouldn't. She should try to poke Echo and not poke the minions, because every time I come by, she's gonna die. Finally gonna go back. Need to spend that gold. Your lead is nothing when you don't spend your gold, so try to do that as fast as possible. I made good use of my buffs though. My buffs just ran out. Red buff is also very good on Trundle. Not only the healing, but also the slow on your auto attacks. You only have two damaging abilities, so you really need to auto attack a lot to get your damage out. And use your Q as an auto attack reset. That's very important with Trundle as well. When I get Triforce, my Q does a lot more damage, because it will also do the Triforce proc immediately. But yeah, that's a long way to go. I see the ward here. My Echo kills the Syndra solo. That's very good, because that's really an oppressive lane for him. But my gank worked. I'm happy with that. Bot lane, same thing. And yeah, if you look at their matchups, the bot lane has a very strong matchup against Kog'Maw and Lulu, but they have a good late game. I'm gonna help my bot lane because they are low. I'm gonna ward for them so they can push out. But we don't push out entirely, so this is a little mistake. Should have pushed it under the tower so Kog'Maw misses a lot, because that's one of the most important things in this game. They have a protector Kog'Maw team comp. You see the Shen, you see the Lulu. And yeah, Kog'Maw late game, even if he is far behind, still a problem. I didn't expect to be spotted by wards. And Lulu takes the red buff. God damn it. It sucks. But yeah, red buff on Lulu is better than on Lee Sin. I'm not totally unhappy with that, but I rather had it for myself, of course. Gonna go for Syndra again. She has a ward now, so she sees me coming, but she's overextended again. Yeah, my pillar is late, because she stuns me. Or my pillar was too early. I think she would have flashed even if I didn't use a pillar, so I maybe could have waited until she flashed and then used pillar, but then she would have been under the turret approximately. So yeah, I don't know if we could have gotten the kill. But she flashed, so next time my pillar will kill her. Kind of rhymes. Pillar, killer. Yeah, okay, I should shut up. Anyways. Just gonna clear. My clear won't get much faster. With attack speed it will get a bit, but yeah, I don't have any AoE. Unstoppable. So I should be ganking a lot early. That's what Trundle wants to do, and I want to split push later on and maybe flank a good team fight. But yeah, I'm not really a good team fighter, because I really need to go in to do my damage. My pillar is of course very good for team fights, but that's about it. My ult is very good to to make the Shen weak. Or the Lee Sin. But Lee Sin is not going to go tank. Gonna go to the bot lane again. They are overextended, and yeah, a pillar is good enough again. Echo was also here, so this was a double kill for sure. It is looking to be quite a stomp, but as I already said, they have a late game team composition. Even if their Kog'Maw is 10 deaths, he will still do a lot of damage when it gets to late game. Gonna help my bot lane get the tower so they can roam. You want that first blood on the tower. Gives a lot of gold. Very valuable. Don't underestimate it. Especially if you can give it to your AD carry alone, you get like 600 gold, something like that, 550 maybe. And yeah, that will snowball you more than a first blood does. So get that first tower as soon as possible. After that you can play it out a little bit slower if you want. A little bit safer and slower is usually good. Nice play. The thought that counts. Okay, gonna try and gank the Syndra with the two of us, I thought, but it's not going. Yeah, we don't really need trash, we just need a pillar. And you can maybe see the pattern here. I just clear my bot side, gank both those lanes, and then go to my top side. That's what I do. It's the third time I do this. And yeah, it's so successful. Purely because the enemy doesn't know how to play safe against the jungler who counters them. And Lee Sin doesn't know how to help. This game, yeah, he probably could have ganked top a lot, and then that Shen can TP and help his team more. Something like that would have been a good game plan for Lee Sin. But yeah, he tried to fight me at 4 minutes. He died for it. And then he was behind the entire game. Gonna help my top lane push out because we see Shen in the bot lane and we need to get those objectives as soon as possible. I don't want to give Kog'Maw his late game. Luckily Trundle's pretty good at taking down towers. We don't know where the team is, so we will back off the safe way. Yeah, we can do Rift Herald now. Imply you to watch my health when Rift Herald dies. And tell me that's not an insane buff. We get spotted here. I flash way too early, but the Rift Herald gives me 700 health. And yeah, I can ult Shen. I'm very tanky now. You see Lee Sin kick me, but it doesn't do any damage. Zero. Flash over. Almost have my pillar back up, so we can catch on him. And there it goes. Yeah, I want to 2v1 if there's a tanky person and a not tanky person. That's one of the best things I can get. Now 1v1 is great as well, but 2v1 is even better, because I don't have a lot of damage, and I don't have damage in a ranged way, except for my ulti, but that's not really a lot of damage. So yeah, that was perfect. Gangplank got the Rift Herald. I smited way too early though. That was stupid. I should always look at how much damage my smite does. I always presume it does 1000 damage, but that's only late game, so I should really look first. In situations where there is no threat of the Rift Herald or Dragon being stolen, I always watch how much my smite does in damage, but yeah, when I'm watching the enemy as well, I don't mind it. And that's something I really need to improve on, because yeah, that's the way you lose a lot of smite wars. I needed 1600 for a spirit visage. Now my healing is just insane. And Syndra can do anything to me. Still need to watch out for the Kog'Maw, but the rest of them is, yeah. We can fight them 3v4. 2v4 maybe, even. Because that spirit visage just makes it so I don't take any magic damage. So Syndra doesn't do any damage. Kog'Maw does less damage. Lulu doesn't do any damage. I can just be in their face the entire time. That's what you want to do. Be aggressive. Take all their farm. Take all their jungle camps. Take all their objectives. Starve them. Because that's the way you you snowball your lead. If you just let them farm, let them do everything they like, you don't... Doesn't matter if you got an elite. They will catch up on you. You don't want it. You want to starve them. Now, the only thing I need to watch out for is the Lee Sin Q. Whenever he Qs this thing, we need to... I wanted to pull it out, but it's hard when you have a team with you. So yeah, I missed my smite as well. But what you do there is, as soon as you see the Lee Sin Q hit the dragon, you stop doing damage. So if he takes a second Q immediately, damage is not even close and he smites. Yeah, a little bit of Clown Fiesta here. I ulti Shen, so I'm pretty tanky. I know Syndra's there, but as I said, Syndra doesn't do any damage to me. They want a red buff, so I'm sticking around, but don't really like these kind of fights. It's just how you throw. Syndra ignites me for free. That's fine by me. But yeah, this is enough. We need to leave. If Lee Sin comes back again, it's a 4v5. And we've gotten a few kills, we've gotten a few cooldowns, a lot of summoner spells, we've gotten the red buff, so I'm happy. Yeah, you don't want to wait around too much, especially when you kill someone and he can revive and come back with new items, new health. That's the way you throw, overstaying. We overstayed a little bit there, but we are so far ahead. It's fine. I'm going back to clearing. Lee Sin is farming pretty well though. I don't know how he did it. He probably got some lane farm somewhere, because Lee Sin does farm faster. He can jump over walls with his Q. He has some AoE, especially with Tiamat. But still, he died 3 times. Too much CC. I'm gonna focus the Kog'Maw because he was focusing my Echo. And yeah, the exhaust fucks me over. That was a Triforce proc. She exhausted. That would have killed him, but yeah, the shield and the exhaust kept him alive. And that's what killed me, because it took too long. Don't know exactly who killed me. Syndra, that's not that bad. As long as Kog'Maw doesn't get all the kills, but he gotten a few kills as well. He bought a Blade of the Ruined King. He's going for Rage Blade next. So it's on hit Kog'Maw. And it will do a lot of damage to me. We see Shen split pushing. I force him to use his taunt. He tries to fight me, but he doesn't know the matchup as well. You can't fight a Trundle. Not as a tank. I just ult him. He loses all his health, magic resist, etc. And my Echo is coming up. My pillar is coming back up. Yes. Here we can finish him. We don't know where the rest of the team is, so we need to watch out a bit. But we have pressure in the mid lane now, and we see a lot of them. So my Echo is going back. Push out the wave. That's good. I can go back to clearing. I'm still behind. Yeah, he must have gotten a lot of lane minions, because he's only a level 11. He just stole farm somewhere, like he's doing now. He's going bot side and stealing the minions. But if he really needs to let Kog'Maw have those, every penny needs to go to Kog'Maw, and they need to. You need to use all the cooldowns to protect Kog'Maw. That's the only way they can win this game. I'm gonna split push now for a bit. Dragon is coming up, so we want this bot lane being pushed out. I'm gonna run towards the dragon. You can just do it. Now I can pull it out, finally, so the Lee Sin Q can't hit it. Always do this against Lee Sin. Now even if he knows we are doing it, he can't stop it. Echo is chasing him. Chasing him away, that's good. We see Kog'Maw here. Yeah, the Lee Sin helps him. Echo is gonna ulti out, so I'm gonna stay alone. And yeah, Kog'Maw shreds me. Need to flash out. He gets a kill on the gangplank. That's not good. We need to close this game out. Need to do it quickly. Best thing to do now is to split push for me, because they can't send Shen. Shen alone will die to me. It will take a very long time to kill him, but He can't kill me with all my lifesteal. And I can kill him, if given enough time. And yeah, I can't really teamfight anymore because the Kog'Maw will just wreck me. I can just... I can teamfight, but I need to flank, I need to get a good pillar, and Echo needs to dive in and kill the Kog'Maw. And when the Kog'Maw is dead, I can do everything I like. Because then there's no threat on the team anymore. So I'm gonna walk towards top lane. Gonna tell my gangplank to group with the team, because his barrels are too important for the team fights. That's a lot of damage. Especially with Triforce Infinity Edge, he can one-shot the team. So if they pressure with four people mid, and I pressure top, if they send two people to me, they can team fight. If they don't send two people to me, I can get the tower. That's the way you split push. So yeah, they are pressuring mid, very good. They're almost to the tower. They need to be careful a little bit. Because I'm not there and it's a 4v5. Yeah, I'm pretty fast in taking towers, especially with Triforce, using my pillar and my W to get those procs. Got the tower. Now I can maybe look for a flank. They got our Lucian though, so we need to be careful. Waiting for the right moment. And now the Syndra and the Kog'Maw alone. Need to go for Kog'Maw first, because he does all the damage. Red smite him. Wanted to go for Syndra, but the Kog'Maw passive is also following me. So yeah, I got a nice flank off, got the Kog'Maw, so now there's no danger. Can get a few hits on the tower. Back off, take his blue. It's important. Syndra does have Morel and Omicron, so she doesn't have mana problems, but this way our Echo skills better. Getting the crab. Using the pillar to squish the crab between me and the pillar, so it doesn't move. I can get it a lot easier, because it's pretty hard for Trundle later on to get the crab. You don't have a stun. Don't know for sure if my E works. I will try it out and put it in the video. I think my E will lower its armor if you place it directly on it. Syndra gets caught, but I was not around. It was pretty bad. Echo kills the Kog'Maw, so that's my trigger to fight. Flash eats the Lulu. And eat the Syndra. And get out with the Trash Lantern. The Gangplank gets to execute. That's nice. Yeah, I want his red buff. I have Smite in a few seconds. It will heal me. Look at that healing. It's just insane. Oh my god. This Trundle healing is just too much. It's more than... It's more than a Garen does. I'm full health, almost full mana. I can just stay here. But yeah, I don't have vision on any of their team. So I need to back off. Because if I die, they should be able to take a lot. So I'm the only real tank. We of course have Thresh, but he's not really tanky yet. He's more going utility. Kog'Maw's not here, so I can just fuck with it, but now they are here. My team is doing the dragon. So I can just help finish that. This was the third cloud drake, I believe. Normally I don't really care much about the cloud drakes, but in our team comp it's pretty good. Thresh has a lot of uses for the cloud drake. I have a lot of uses for the cloud drake. Echo has a lot of uses for it. So yeah, that's not bad at all. So to be coming back at my statement in the beginning of the game, I said Trundle counters their entire team. I hope you now know why. I counter their tanks with my ult. I counter their jungle pick with my jungle pick. I'm just way stronger than Lee Sin at all stages of the game. And I counter their mid lane and their bot lane with my pillar. So yeah, I have a counter for everything. And they of course counter me with some things as well. Lissandra has a pushback. I don't really like those. And Lulu has a speed up and a knock up and stuff. And it's not really too good as well. A very bad pillar from me here. I should have hit that. That Lulu should have been a free kill. But I misplaced my my pillar. Lee Sin kind of counters me with his ability, mobility. And Shen kind of counters me with his dodge field, but it's just not enough. Here I go a little bit ham. I get focused by everyone and the tower. And yeah, that's a little bit too much. If Kog'Maw doesn't have his W, I can maybe do that, but just turn on his W. And poked me to death. He did like 1,000 damage. The tower did almost 1,000 damage. And the Syndra did like 500. We can just do Baron. Echo is still dead, but we can do it fast enough. This gangplank shouldn't be walking behind Baron. The Baron does more damage on the backside. And it's harder to count. Harder to see if the right person is tanking or not. So just stay in front of the Baron if you can. We got a team fight. I backed off a little bit too hard. My team still wants to go hard and my Echo is now here. Nice taunt by Shen. It saved saved our Kog'Maw. He needs to flash out. And now the Kog'Maw is in front. And as soon as he dies, we can just push. Lucian is going back. That's not good. Should have kept pushing. Because Kog'Maw has all that damage. We can dive if Syndra stays too close. Yeah, that's too close. Our gangplank dies though, so that's a lot of our pushing power. Getting some damage on the turret. But the turret gets some damage on me. A little bit too much, now I can't fight them anymore. But Thresh gets a good lantern. And we can get out. Nice plays by Thresh. He's a good player. Getting this for the Elder Drake. Or maybe Inferno, I don't know. Should be an Elder. After 35 minutes, but yeah. At the top left of the screen you see a picture of an Inferno Drake, so I'm not sure what's gonna happen there. We still have Baron. I'm gonna split in the bot lane again. We need to split that team up. Because they have a very good team fight. Ours is not bad either. Our gangplank is kind of the same thing as Kog'Maw. I wanted to go look for the CZ Rod portal. Didn't expect them to be here. But yeah, they can't really kill me. I ult the Shen. And then they don't do any damage. Shen is going away. So now I can fight Lee Sin. Yeah, not really gonna chase him. His mobility counters me, so... My team comes to my lane, that's very good. When it hits the tower, now we can get a free tower. And mid lane is pressure as well. So they can get a tower. Trying to annoy Lee a little bit. Got to still have Baron. So we can maybe push down another turret. The gangplank gets a good barrel. And we win. Yeah, that's the Kog'Maw. Echo gets him. Now we can just finish it off. We shouldn't have fought in front of the turret. Because now we can finish it. So yeah. I hope you enjoyed this game. And you'll hear from me next time. Have a nice day.